Hello everyone, in this tutorial we will learn how we can make maze game in Scratch. So let's start. Quickly we will draw the backdrop. For that just go to your stage and just select paint. This is your canvas where you can draw, and these are the different tools for drawing. So I am taking this rectangle. You can draw rectangle here and take any color of your choice. For color you just go to fill and select, let's suppose I want to take this blue color. Now click here, draw one more rectangle here and then the third one and then the fourth one, like this. Okay, this is the simplest design for maze, that's why I have taken this. You can take other one also. Now here I want to make the starting point. For that I want to take this circle, select the color, let's suppose yellow, and then the finishing line should be there. For that I'm taking this rectangle and draw your rectangle here and change the color also. So it's green. Now come back from this. Here you can see the size of cat is too big, so we can make it small. For that just select it first of all. See, if it is not selected you can't change the size, so you need to select the size, select the sprite first and then change the size. So I'm making it 50. This is perfect and I'm putting it on the circle. Fine. Now at the finishing line I want to put any other sprite, so let's suppose it is going to be a rat. So choose your rat or mouse from here. Okay, this is the mouse, and now we can change size also. So you can see the mouse is selected. Now we can change the size, so let's make it 40. Yeah, perfect. So like this you can see, this is the layout for the game. This is the starting point where cat is standing and this is the finishing point where mouse is capped. Now time to do the code. I want to move my cat in all the direction. For that first of all, first you understand what is y direction and what is x direction. So let's suppose my cat is in center. Okay, just hold on. This cat is in center. If it is going up or down, this is your y. Okay, this is your y axis. If your cat is going left and right, this is your x direction. Okay, or x axis you can say. Up and down means your y axis. Left and right means your x-axis. So please keep in your mind these two terms, x and y. Now initially I want my cat to be stand here only. Whenever I am going to click on this flag, it should be on circle only. Suppose by mistake if you have put it here and you are starting your game, so you need to click on flag and then it should come back to the circle. For that what will be the code, let's see. For that just go to events and select your flag. Okay, and then go to motion. From the motion select, go to x and y. These are the axes or the area where your cat is initially, so just drag it here. No need to change the x and y. Okay, now see, if I am putting it here and clicking on flag, it will come back. You can see it is here and now it will come back. Now time to move it up and down. Okay, so again just go to events and select when, key pressed. Okay, now which key you want to press? Up arrow key. So select. See, here you can see the whole list. list of alphabets, numbers and different keys. So I am taking this up arrow key because I want to move my cat upside. And then up means your Y direction. So just check for Y. This is here, change Y by 10. So put it here. Okay, now try from the keyboard. Press up arrow key from the keyboard. See, it is going up. Okay, it is going up. Now if you want to put it down, you need to use down arrow key also. For that also we will write the code. So the shortcut is you just duplicate it, right click on it and duplicate, and click it, put it here, and from the drop down list select the down arrow key. Okay, now only one change you have to make here, where you have written change Y by 10, just make it minus 10. Okay, because it is going down, so down position will be minus. So now you can try, click on flag, or I am just making it big. Now see, up arrow key it is going up, down arrow key it is coming down. Okay, so it is going up and down. Now let's do the code for right. See, it is not going right, so we need to do code for that also. Again, just go in events, take this when key pressed, and please keep some gap here because we have to put some other code also. And now from here select your right arrow key, and as I told you that for right and left we will use X axis. So just go in motion and look for X. So this is your X, change X by 10, put it here. Now check, yes, it is going, now it is going up, down and then right. Okay, time to work on left arrow key. So again we will duplicate it, put it here, and we'll change here right to left, and here in change X by, it will also become minus 10. That's it. So let's see, is it working or not. Up, down, left, right. Okay, so it means my cat is moving in all direction, left, right, up and down. Okay, now what is the next things we have to do? Suppose if my cat is moving and it is going to touch this blue bar, okay, this blue bar, then what should happen? It should not go beyond it. Why? Because this is the barrier, or this is the ball which it cannot cross. In this case it should go to the first position only automatically. Okay, means you have to play your game again. So let's see how we can do that. Here in the category, just go to control. Okay, in control you will find this if then, drag it under this code. Now if cat is going to touch this blue color, okay, if cat is going to touch this blue color, that time it should give some message and will come back to its original position. So let's see how we will do that. Go to sensing now and touching color, drag it here on this diamond box. Okay, and from the color, just can you see this hand, click here, and then this is the color picker, click on this color picker and then go to the blue color. See, can you see the small square is coming? When your small square is coming on the blue color, click. Okay, now you see automatically color has been changed. It means if cat is going to touch blue color, it should give some message. So message will come in looks category, select this, And here the first one you can take like this and type your message, any message you can give. I want to give a try again. And then after giving this message for 2 seconds, it should go its original position. So for that we will go here in motion and we'll select the position. That's it. Okay, this is the same position which where it was earlier. Now what we will do, this should be for all four direction, means if in any direction it is going to touch the blue color or the blue bar, it should give some message like try again, and the cat should go to its original position. So just right click, duplicate and put it under this code. Again duplicate and put it under this code. Okay, and same for the fourth one, duplicate and put it here. Clear? So let's check if it is going to touch blue bar. Oh, try again and see, the cat is on its original position. See, again in any direction, if it is go, see, if I'm pressing left, again it is going to touch, try again, and the original position. If I'm going to touch it like by using the up arrow key, again. Why? Because we have given code for all the direction. Now what else should be here? If this cat is going to touch this green color, it means it is going to touch the finishing line and going to catch the mouse. So that time also it should give some message. Yes. So let's see. Again we will go to control, we'll take if, put it here, then again we'll go to sensing. It will sense which color is cat is going to touch, then select the color, select the picker, and now just move your mouse on the green color because we need to touch the green color. Yes, you can see this green has come, and now it should give some message. This time we are going to take this message without any timings. Earlier we have taken this for 2 seconds, but here for always. So I'm going to put it here, and you are winner. Okay, and I'm going to copy this code or duplicate this code for all four keys. Okay, this is very simple game. Oh, sorry. Okay, now let's see what is going to happen. If I am going up and it is going to touch it, oh, try again, go this, and now yay, you are winner. Okay, so like this you can play game. You can add sound to your game while playing. That we will learn in next tutorial. Thanks for watching.